Forgive me if I cannot pronounce most of these words. If I speak in the tongues of men and angels, but have not love, I am a noisy gong, a clanging cymbal. And if I have the powers.
It's all right, babe. Take your time.
Come on.
And understand. All the mystery, all knowledge. If I have all faith, some to remove mountains, but I have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, if I deliver, to be murdered, but I have not love, I gain nothing. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist or own way. It is simple. It does not rejoice or wrong, but rejoices with the truth. Love makes all things. Believe all things, hope all things, and endures all things. Love never ends. As for the prophecies, they will pass away. As for the prophecies, they will be. As for the knowledge, they will pass away. For all to know in part, prophecies in part, when it was perfect, my soul was passed away. When I was a child, I spoke like a child, I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. And when I became a man, I gave up childish acts. For now, we see from mirror dimly and face to face. Now I know in part, and I shall know fully, even as I have been full grown. So now all faith.
I think I've started and stopped writing these vows about 100 times. I've even dreamed about them. But no matter how many times they've come across my mind, three words were always in the midst of them. Searching, praying, and blessing. I was not searching for love. I was searching for myself, and most of all, I was searching for happiness. When it didn't come, I made a conscious decision to close myself off from people and things that didn't bring me happiness. But in the process of that, I noticed that I wasn't happy. Instead, I was even more miserable. We all know that God never intended for anyone to be on this earth alone. And I started to understand that. So I prayed, and I prayed for very specific things. Someone to love me, and to love Madison like she was their own. Someone who made me happy and brought me peace of mind, and someone who would make me feel safe. And then, on a Saturday afternoon, while watching the best team in college football, God blessed me with you and the win. You are everything I prayed for. You are everything that I didn't even know I needed. And I can't imagine how I managed to live without. So today, in front of God and our family, I promise to be the best woman I can for you and our children, to support you, to defend you, and love you with all of my heart and soul. I love you. That's what I'm going to do.
When I met you, I was lost. I had given up on love. I never thought I could ever be happy again. You changed that from day one, from that beautiful smile of yours. friend, my love,
my real. I promise to encourage your passion, compassion, because that is what makes you unique and wonderful. I promise to nurture your dreams, because through them, your soul shines. I promise to help shoulder our challenges. For there is nothing we cannot face if we stand together. I promise to be your partner in all things. Not possessing you, but working with you. Last but not least, perfect love and perfect trust. For one lifetime with you could never be enough. This is my sacred vow to you, my equal in all things.
Peter, as you all know, you've already exchanged rings. Probably going to be some news. John, bring me with his ring.
With this ring.
I do wish. And for all my worldly goods.
And with all my worldly goods.
I'll be endowed. In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Ghost.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen.
O eternal God, creator and preserver of all mankind, giver of all spiritual grace, the honor of everlasting life, send thy blessing upon these, thy servants, this man and this woman, whom we bless in thy name, that is Isaac and Rebecca be available together, so these persons may surely perform and keep the vow and covenant between them made. For of this ring given and received as a token and a pledge, and may ever remain in perfect love, peace together, and live according to thy laws through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Well, therefore, God hath joined together, let not man put asunder. For as much as John and Brandy have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and this company, here too have given and pledged their troth each to the other, and have declared the same by giving and receiving a ring, and by joining hands, I pronounce that they are man and wife, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. You may salute your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you a great honor and privilege, Mr. and Mrs. John Wilson. I'm